Hi, I welcome you all for my fourth video lecture on course Digital Logic. Today we are going to discuss two topics. First one is K-map. We are going to solve four variable and five variable K-maps, and followed by we are going to discuss about DORCAS and what are the roles played by the DORCAS in K-map. Okay, before going to today's topic, we are going to recap what are the topics that we had discussed in the previous class. In the previous class, we have started with K-map, right? What is the role of K-map in Boolean expression simplification? It plays a vital role. It reduces the time in simplifying the Boolean expressions compared to simplifying the Boolean expressions using Boolean theorems. When we need to come for an K-map, if the number of literals involved is very less, we can solve it using, or we can simplify it using Boolean theorems itself. If the number of literals or variables are more in the Boolean expression, then we can solve it very comfortably using a K-map. And one more important point we need to know in relevance with the K-map is the binary code used in that. The binary code used in K-map is gray code. Using a gray code only, the entire K-map is working. Okay. And then we have seen about in what all the ways we can perform, or we can make the combinations in the map. We can form a octet. Octet is nothing but covering of 8 ones. And we can form a quad if octet is not present. Quad is nothing but covering 4 ones. If quad is not present, we need to go for a pair. Pair is nothing but a covering of 2 ones. And finally, even if a pair is not available, we need to go for a single one marking. Our aim in K-map is, in terms of a sum of product terms, we need to cover all the ones. In the term of a product of sums simplification, we need to cover all the zeros. Okay. Now we'll come to K-map, 4 variable and 5 variable maps. Before going to that, we'll solve some more problems in 3 variable. Okay.
Yeah. Simplify f of ABC equal to sigma m 0, 2, 4, 6.
As I have already told you about that, how to find whether a given problem is under a particular variable map. Okay. We need to look into the maximum min term or max term given in the problem, based on which we need to identify whether it is a 3 variable map or 2 variable map or 4 variable map and so on. Now you look into the maximum min term of this problem. It is 6. How many bits are required to represent 6? 3 bits. That is 110. So obviously it is going to fit in a 3 variable map. Okay. So we know that 3 variable map means how many cells in a map? 8 cells. Okay. 1, yes, A, B, C. So we know that A means is a single variable. It is going to take 2 bit values, 0 and 1. B, C means it is going to take 4 different values. That is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Why here 1, 1 means? I have already told you that gray code is used in K-map. Okay. That is the reason after 0, 1, we are having 1, 1. Now we will try to plot this given problem. 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0 is 0. 0 is given in the problem, so 1. 0, 0, 1 is 1. 1 is not given in the problem. We are going to left it blank. 0, 0, 1 is 3. We are going to left it blank because 3 is not given in the problem. 0, 1, 0 is 2. So we are going to plot 1 here. Okay, 100, 100 is nothing but 4. 4 is also given in a problem. 101 is not part of the problem. because 101 is 5, 1111 is 7, 7 is also not part of the problem, and 110 is 6, it is given in the problem, so on. Okay, so we have spoken about pair covering, quad, octet, all those things. Okay, now we are going to see one more combination called as a folding method. If the bits in the same position which are present in two different corners, then we can apply a folding method. Now you can see in this problem here, the bits ones are present in the two different corners, the leftmost corner and the rightmost corner, in the same position. Then we can apply a fold is nothing but folding, like folding the page of a book. If you fold like this, what will happen? Which of the bits of BC will be compared? 0, 0 and 1, 0 will be compared. But across the column, A will be compared. So A value, bits are different, that is 0 and 1 are different. A is going to be neglected. While folding this way, which of all the bits will be compared? 0, 0, 1, 0. What is the common bit between 0, 0 and 1, 0? 0. 0 corresponds to? 0 corresponds to C, so we will be getting C dash. Okay. Now we'll try one more problem. Simplify. F equal to sigma m 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? Okay. A, B, C, okay. 0, 1 here, here 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So what is the value? So I think almost all the values are given in the problem. So we'll be plotting 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So what combination we can go with? So we have talked about all the combinations. If we need to give a preference to the higher combination. So here we can form a quad. Rather than we are forming we can form an octet, not a quad. We can form an octet because it is our higher combination. So you need not to go for quad or either for pair. Because if your map contains an higher combination, you need to give preference for that only. So this problem contains octet. Octet is nothing but 8 ones. We are covering 8 ones. And moreover, I have already told you in the previous sessions that if all the cells are occupied with 1 in a given map, the result is what? 1. Okay. Here also, it is a 3 variable map. So, 8 cells, all the 8 cells are occupied with 1s. So, we are getting the value as 1. Okay. Now we'll come for today's topic, that is four variable map. Okay. Four variable map. So we know that, so if there are n variables, there will be 2 power n cells in the map. So now, by that definition, now we are going to solve four variable map. So we are going to have how many cells? Yeah, there are 16 cells in the map. We'll directly go to the problem, how we are going to proceed with. So simplify F equal to sigma m 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11, 12. Like this, we'll take, okay? Four variables, so how many cells? 16. So we have to form 16 cells. So four variables A, B, C, D. So here also two variables. Two variables means how many combinations will come? Four combinations. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Here also C, D, it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. 0, 0, 0, 0. It's nothing but 0. 0 is given in a problem. And 0, 0, 1 is 1. That is also given in a problem. 0, 0, 1, 1 is 3. Given in problem. 0, 0, 1, 0. It is also given in the problem. 0, 1, 0, 0. Which is also given in the problem. That is 5. Sorry, 0, 1, 0, 0. Which is nothing but 4. 0, 1, 0, 1 is 5. Then 11. 11 is nothing but 1, 0, 1, 1. 1, 0, 1, 1. And then 12 is 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay. Is it clear? So these are we have plotted. Okay. And now you tell me what all the combinations will come. I think we will go for quad here. So 4 ones are here. 4 ones are here. Quad. And one more quad we can form using this, you know, for using this 4 ones. Okay, and one more pair we can do here for these two. Is it clear? Then we need to go for a single park, or otherwise we can form a fold here. We can go for single combination. So far we have not talked about this combination, so I am going for this. So now we will write the terms. For this first quad, across the row we are taking CD. So everything is covered. So the bits are different. So we will be taking only the value of AB. So AB is 0, 0. So we are going to write this A dash, B dash. Now we will come to this quad. It is going like this. Okay, we need to see across the column as well as the row. While going across the column, the two values 0, 0 and 0, 1 are, we need to find the common bit. What is the common bit here? 0, 0 corresponds to A. So we'll be getting A dash. While coming this way, two values, that is 0, 0, 0, 1. Here also 0 is common, that corresponds to C. So C dash, A dash, C dash. And then now we'll see that if we look at the pair. Pair means we need to see across the column as well as the this value AB and as well as CD. So seeing across the column 0, 1, 1, 1. So what is the common bit here? 1. 1 corresponds to B. That is B. Here it corresponds to the value, bit 0, 0. That relates to CD, so B, C dash, D dash. And single one, so what we need to do? A, B dash, and then the corresponding value of CD is CD. We need to write the both by combining this row and column value, that is A, B dash, CD. Okay. Is it clear? Right. Now we'll go for another problem. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay, we'll take this problem. So 0 means 0, 0, 0. So it is, we are going to plot 1, 2, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 4, 0, 1, 0, 0, 6, 0, 1, 1, 0, and then 8, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, and then 10, 1, 0, 1, 0, then 12, 1, 1, 0, 0, and then 14, 1, 1, 0. Okay, I think you know this combination. So if you get the ones in the same position in two different corners, we can go for folding, right? Folding. Okay, so across the column A, across the value of AB, the bits are different, so AB won't be coming, right? We need to compare the values of CD, that is 0, 0 and 1, 0. The common bit is 0, that corresponds to D dash. Okay. Right. So this is how you need to solve different problems under 4 variable map. We'll see some more problems under 4 variable map. Yeah, we'll go for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, right. 0. 0, 0 means 1. 0, 0, 1 means 1. 2 is here. 3 is here. 4. 0, 1, 0, 0 is 4. 5. Then 6. Yes, 7. Then 12. 12 is 1, 1, 0, 0 is 12. 1, 1, 0 is 13. 1, 1, 0 is 14. Yeah, 15. Okay. Now, what we can form, or which combination we can do, whether we can go for quad or octet. Yeah, we can go for an octet. Yes. For this, we can go for another octet by making use of the existing combination. Okay, for covering these four ones, we can make use of the another four ones that had been already covered. Okay. So two octets we have covered. Okay. So F equal to, what is the first octet? First octet means it is across CD we have to see. So all the bit values are different. So CD won't come. We need to see across AB. What is the common bit? 0, 0 corresponds to A, so A dash. Come to this octet. For this also CD is not going to come. We need to see across AB. What is the common bit here? 1, 1 corresponds to B. So F equal to A dash plus B. Is it clear? So this is how we need to proceed with K-map. So it is going to take very less time. That is the advantage of an K-map simplification. Okay. Shall I erase this? Yeah. Yeah, I think we have solved some sufficient number of problems under 4 variable. Now we'll get into 5 variable maps. Okay. So 5 variable map. 5 variable map means what? So it is going to occupy 32 cells in a given map. So rather than solving as a single problem, we can solve this 5 variable map as 2-4 variable maps. That will be easy to understand, right? So rather than we can solve as a single problem also, but it is better to solve that 5 variable map as 2-4 variable maps, right? So totally we need to get 32 cells. So for each 4 variable map, we'll be getting 16 cells. So totally 32 cells, right? Now we'll go for an example. How we need to solve? If you are going with 2-4 variable map, means we need to solve 2-4 variable maps independently, and we need to combine the result of both the 4 variable maps, and we need to simplify it using Boolean theorems if anything has to be reduced further. Okay.
F equal to sigma m 0, 1, 5, 7, 30, 31.
Okay. We'll see. So how to separate? What are the values will come in first 4 variable map, and what are the other values will come in second 4 variable map? Yeah. That is, so the values in this 5 variable map range from 0 to 31. So each value is going to have an 5 bit, right? So the values from 0 to 15, value starts from 0. After 15, the value will start with 1. The rest of the 4 bits will be same. Is it clear? That is, 0 to 15 will be beginning with the bit called as 0, and the rest of the 4 bits will be very same after 15. That will begin with 1. Okay. So now we'll solve this. How we are going to solve this? The first 0 to 15 will be plotted in the first 4 variable map. By having the first bit the outside. So the first 0 to 15 will start with 0. The remaining 4 bits will be same. From 16 to 31, the starting bit would be 1, and the remaining 4 bits would be same as what we have seen in the 0 to 15. So the only bit change from 0 to 15 and 16 to 31 is the first bit. That is, for the first bit would be 0 from 0 to 15 and 1 from 16 to 31. Okay. So that is why I am putting A dash equal to 0. B, C, D, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So we need to combine along with the A variable. Okay. This is the first variable. This is the first 4 variable map and second 4 variable map. Sorry. A equal to 1. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Okay. So for the first 4 variable map, we are going to plot the values from 0 to 15. Second 4 variable map, we are going to plot the values from 16 to 31. Okay.
Yeah, first 0. So 0 means 5 0 should be there. So we need to see along with the value of A, B, C, D. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So 1. Then 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. 1. Then 5 is 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. Yeah. Then 7, 0, 0, 1, 1. Is it clear? Right? So the other values are beyond 15. So we need to go for the next four variable, that is 30. 30 we need to start with 1, that is A. Then what we need to get? 1 4 1 0. 1 1 1 1 0. So here we are going to put it here, and then 5 1s. 1 1 1 1 1. So we are going to plot it here. Okay. So this way we are going to pair it. Here also we are going to pair it. Okay. So this is going to be F1, and this is going to be F2. That is, the entire f function is split into two different functions, that is f1 and f2. We are going to combine the results of f1 f2 so that we are going to get the finalized result for f. Okay, what is f1? So here the common bits are 0. 0 corresponds to b, so we are going to take the value of bc as it is, b bar c bar. The first variable would be always A dash. So A dash, B dash, C dash. Then here, what is the first variable? D dash. The common bit is 0, that corresponds to D. Plus here, obviously the first variable would be A dash. What is the common bit in the case of a D? That corresponds to E. Here we need to write B dash C, that is B dash C E, right? A dash B dash C, and then here common bit is 1 1, corresponds to E. Okay, this is F1. What is F2? First variable would be A as it is. Here we are going to write BC, because 1 1. What is the common bit across DE? Common bit is 1, that corresponds to D. So what is the value? A, B, C, and then D. A, B, C. A, B, C is the value. Now we'll write the final result. F equal to F1 plus F2. What is F1? A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, plus A dash, B dash, C E, plus A B C D. Okay. If you are able to reduce further, if you are able to reduce further using Boolean theorems, we can reduce it, or otherwise this is our final result. This is how we need to solve the five variable map. Okay, so there are two methods of solving the five variable map. The straightforward method is solving as a single K map, or otherwise for further simplification we can solve the five variable map as 2 4 variable maps. That is what we have seen as an example. Okay, next we'll go for a Donkas. Donkas. Donkas are the input sequences that may not have an impact on the actual output of a given Boolean function.
But these terms will be useful for simplifying the Boolean expression. Okay. So don't care terms, as the name implies, you need not to bother about that term. If that particular term would be useful for simplifying the expression, you can include it. Otherwise, you need not to bother about that term. Right? That is nothing but don't care terms. Okay. Don't care terms will be represented by x, which means x can be either 0 or x can be either 0 or 1. If you want to include that don't care term for simplification, you can assume that x value as 1 in the case of an sum of min terms expansion, and you can assume as a 0 when you are solving it for product of max terms expansion. Okay. And one more important point is, you need not to cover don't care terms alone. That is, while you are forming a combination, there should be at least one min term or maximum. That is, there must be at least 1 1 or 1 0. Clear? Now we'll go for the problem. Yeah. Simplify f equal to sigma m 6789. Plus sigma d is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Clear? So this problem involves both the min terms as well as the don't cares. So don't cares has been represented by suffix d. Clear? So obviously it is a 4 variable map. Yeah, 6 will be coming here, 0 1 1 0 1 1 0, that is 6, 7 is 0 1 1, 8 is 1 0 0, that is here, and then 1 0 0 1, that is 9. This is min terms. The don't care terms we are going to represent as a by x. 10, what is the 1 0 1 0 is x. 1 0 1 1, that is 11x, and then 12 1 1 0 0 x, 13 1 1 0 1, and 14, and then 15. Okay, so be clear that you should not form don't care alone. That is, as I already told you previously, so there should be either at least 1 1 or 1 0s while you are solving the sum of min term expansion or product of max terms expansion. Now you can see that if don't care terms will be useful for simplifying the expression, you can include it. For example, rather than going for pair, you can make use of these two don't cares to form a quad. Quad will reduce better than forming a pair, right? So I am first forming quad. Yeah. And then what are the other combinations you can go? Whether you can go for this quad or octet. You can go for an octet. So that will reduce further, right? Because we'll be having ones here. So we have form an octet here. Okay. Now we'll write the expressions. For this quad across AB, what are the common bits? 1, that corresponds to B. Across CD, 1 1 1 0, that corresponds, the common bit is 1, that corresponds to C. So BC, then plus
will come to an quad. So across CD, there won't be any common bits, so CD won't be coming. So we need to see across AB, what is the common bit? 1 that corresponds to A. So BC plus A or A plus BC is the answer. Clear? We'll go for one more problem. Is it clear how it is useful? If it is useful, you can include the don't care terms. Otherwise, you can simply neglect that term. Okay, that is the idea of an don't cares. Simplify F equal to sigma n 1, 5, 6, 12, 13, 14 plus sigma d is 2, 4. Okay, we have two don't care terms here. Now we'll start with the A, B, C, D, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Right? So, 0, 0, 1, that is 1 is given the term. And then 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1 is 5. 0, 1, 1, 0 is 1. 12 is 1, 1, 0, 0 is 1. 13 is 1, 1, 0, 1. 14 is 111, 0. How many are there? 6. Yeah. 2 and 4 are the don't care terms. 2. Where is 2? 0, 0, 1, 0. Then 4. 0, 1, 0, 0. Okay. Yeah. Now we can use it. How we can go for this? Now we can use this don't care. Right? That is useful for forming the quad. So we are using this don't care, and we are going to form a pair here. And we need not to use this don't care term because no way it is going to helpful for simplifying the expression. Just form a pair using once alone. Our aim is to cover once, not the don't cares. Very importantly, in the problems involving the don't care terms. If the don't care terms would be helpful, then we can include, or otherwise we need not to bother about the don't care terms. Our main motive is to cover all the ones. Okay. Now I think you have known the purpose of don't care by this problem. So F equal to, look into this quad across AB. What is the common bit? 1. The 1 corresponds to B. Across CD, common bit is 0 that corresponds to C. So C dash, B, C dash. Now we will come to this pair. Across AB, bit is 0. Bit 0 is common. That corresponds to A. So A dash. Here we need to write the corresponding bits of bits across the CD. That is A dash, C dash, D. Plus for this pair. Across AB, the bit 1 is common. That corresponds to B. And we need to write the corresponding CD bits. So C D dash. So this is how we need to work with the don't care problems. I think we have come to the end of the session. We'll see the rest of the topics in the coming session. Thank you.